हल्की
हल्की है बच्चे पीछे
हल्की हो कल की है
कल की है
कल की है
थैंक यू
वेट वेट
सर यहाँ पे
Rohan, we have Dinesh ji with us, who's also one of the producers. Anil ji, Jay ji, who recently joined us as co-producers. Aditya, who's the associate director. Ishan, and of course, Shil Aditya. Who else? Nicholas, Parul, where's Parul? Shilpi, Apurva, okay, that's it, I think. Nicholas, do you want to say something?
No, if there are any questions, we're happy to answer them. The film was partly crowdfunded. As Nikhil said, we had a lot of people helping us with a whole bunch of things, all kinds of favors, from, you know, getting TVs from people and cars and free food. Just about everything, but that's how the film was made, and we're grateful to a whole bunch of people. But if you have any questions, maybe that's a better way to proceed. Yeah, it is. It was fairly simple because it was changing right before us, right? I mean, for all of us who are in our 40s, etc., you know, you're seeing that transition for a whole lot of us who are I've seen that transition from the from the India in the 80s, which was more very bureaucratic, etc., to the opening up of the economy in 1991, and things changed dramatically for all of us. So by the late 90s and the early 2000s, it was very apparent the country was changing in a huge way. So I did want to write about it. So I did a lot of research, you know, a lot of Indian companies that kind of survived the multinationals coming, a lot of companies that died because the multinationals came and just completely, you know, took over the market, etc. So much was changing. You know, we had Domino's and McDonald's and all of that coming, and it was very big, you know, at that time. So I did want to write about that change.
I was in touch with Nicholas for a long time before the film was made, so I knew the script very well. I had read many drafts of it, so I was already connected with the film, you know. So finally, 2 years back when he said that he's got the money, it was really exciting. So I think to prepare for a role, I think just reading the script enough is good now. Yeah.
See, I don't think main kafi busy hu. I think I just get lucky with the kind of people who come my way. And again, ye script bahut acha tha. And Pia's character, my character is called Pia. She's a very stubborn, typical modern young girl, 25 years old, jo abhi bhi ghar pe rehti hai parents ke saath. Or that, you know, that struggle of wanting to be independent but still, you know, having to live under the house rules and all of that. So that's a struggle.
Hi Kalki Shiv. Being in the glamour industry, aisa koi aap logo ka mantra hai ki how to survive in Bollywood ya glamour industry ka jo pressure hota hai usko cope up karne ke liye, aisa koi mantra hai aap dono?
So we've already done this on Facebook. My mantra is a Japanese proverb which says, today better than yesterday, worse than tomorrow.
You know, I keep telling my father yaar ki aap director kyun nahi bane, but unfortunately he works for the government. So my mantra to survive in the industry is to just as cliched as it sounds, is just to keep on going and keep on working, because I think somehow the busier you are, the more work you keep getting.
Rajat, aapse ek sawal hai. Pichle kai saalon mein aapne bahut sari indie filmein banayi hain, unko badhava diya. Aapko lagta hai ki pichle 15 saalon mein, 10 saalon mein aur ab mein kitna antar aaya hai, kitna scenario change hua hai aapke hisab se?
Aapko
kitna aasan hai is tarah ki log?
Aapko kya lagta hai?
Matlab main aapko janna chahta hu.
I'll answer that, but aapko kya lagta hai?
Mujhe lag raha hai ki kafi badhava mila hai aur bahut aisi filmein aa rahi hain.
You know, I feel that the high point of so-called indie cinema was from 2003 to 2008. That's when we really saw a revival of this kind of cinema, because multiplexes were new at that time, and that became our space and the space for our audience and our cinema. But post 2008, 2009, there has been a resurgence of the mainstream cinema, and it has, I think, more or less killed everything else. Or taken away the chance for it to survive. So what happens now that a film, a regular mainstream film, comes out in 3,000, 4,000 screens, and that doesn't leave any space for anything else. So the big struggle now, besides making the film, is to get it out there. Where do you show such a film? You know, so that has become a big struggle.
आपको लगता है कि audience भी इसके लिए जिम्मेदार है जो इस तरह की?
बिल्कुल, because audience eventually wants to watch a big film with a big star, and that has not changed and that will not change. And they don't want to watch our films paying money for it. They said, "Achha, ye film aaye, it looks interesting, I'll see it on torrent," you know, but they don't want to spend 300 rupees to watch something like this. So that will change eventually, maybe after 10 years, I don't know, hopefully it will change.
Hi guys, Karmic here from iKarmic.com. congratulations on a fantastic trailer. I think it's really high on the intrigue value, and the curiosity is really gunning me to, you know, really go and watch it out. And I'm going to pay 300 or 400, whatever it is.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Even you can get a complimentary pass, I'm sure.
All right. So no, the question would be to, I think, to the director or anyone else who can answer it better than him, perhaps, is the title is very intriguing as well, Mantra. So whose mantra is this? Is this the mantra of life or family, or how does that get justified?
Well, the way I understand it, which is only one way to look at it, is in this very casual way, which is that, you know, the film straddles the old India and the new India. So there's a transition. There's a transition between, you know, how things were in you know, before 1991 and after globalization. So mantra also is a word which is used by, you know, everybody in this very casual way. You say, this is my mantra for happiness, this is my mantra for doing things right, etc. But it's also a very ancient word, right? It's a word that goes back to the Vedic times, and it, you know, goes right back to tradition as it stands then. So it's a word that straddles the old and the new, and I thought it was a good way to reflect the film and how it stood for the old India and the new India as well.
Right. And the next question goes to the youngest member of the cast. How was it playing a lesbian?
I was.
I'm prepared
for it. I was just
it.
Passing by, and Nicholas said, "Hey, you wanna come? Movie happened." No, I was very young when we shot this. I was 19. Now I'm 21. So yeah, things have changed. But I'm still a lesbian. On a more serious note, it was one of life's highest points so far in all my 21 years of existence. It's nothing's even come close to working with such fabulous people, and you know.
Yeah, but the question is still kind of unanswered. How was it? I mean, how did you prepare for, I mean, you know, a character like this, especially where you have to, you know, say dialogues like those, and you run a risk, especially at your age. We've all been through that, adolescence, and, you know, you run the risk of, you know, being trolled or being spoken off with your friends where, you know, they kind of bully you or, you know, perhaps don't take it as well as they should. So just take me through a little bit.
Add something here. He's taken it very well. The name of his next web series is called Quickie.
You're not supposed to say that. But Nicholas told me I'll be playing Veer, who's a cyber exhibitionist. So my first response was, what is that? So I googled what cyber exhibitionists are, and I was kind of taken aback because I've never done that in my real life. Google came to my help. I saw videos. I only for research purposes. So my parents still don't know much about the movie or my character. So don't anyone. Sorry, mom. I wish I could say I did a lot of research and, you know, method acting. You know, I didn't. I just like I came naturally to me because I was like, wait, this is playing me. It's okay. It's, I was very comfortable playing lead.
That's for them to decide, I think. The director had a vision, which, I mean, of course, he tried to convey it through the film, and now it's up to the audience ki kya lena chahenge film se.
Kalki Shiv, aap dono ne Shaitan mein ek saath kaam kiya tha. Kaafi saal ho gaye hain usko film ko, 4-5 saal. Is dauran aap dono mein kya kuch badla, agar aap dono ek dusre ke bare mein kuch bata paye? How you people have discovered each other after working Shaitan now?
I think first time Kalki saw me on this film, she's like, tu bhi hai isme. I think the dynamic Kalki and me were sharing as Shaitan was like diametrically opposite as to the dynamic we're sharing here. Here we're playing brother and sister, there we're playing.
Yeah,
she killed me. What helped, I think, for this film was that Violent Shaitan, I met her for the first time, and you know, we had to kind of, like any two human beings, to kind of develop a rapport with each other. Here the rapport, I think, already existed, and there hadn't been any change, even though there was a gap of a few years in the middle. So it was very comfortable for me to work with her again, and in fact I was looking forward to working with her, because in Shaitan, it was kind of, you know, we were this young bunch of kids together, having kind of sometimes sexual, sometimes romantic, sometimes friendly kind of a vibe towards each other. Yahan pe we were playing brother and sister, so it was interesting to see that dynamic.
I think Shaitan ke time pe I could never hear Shiv Pandit. He used to talk very very low, in a low volume, and I'd be like, kya bola? Kyun khatam ho gaya? Main karu, main meri line karu. And abhi to I can hear his dialogue. So you know, he has come a long way, and I'm sure that there are many things about me that he has seen change.
In Shaitan, there was this one scene where I finished my dialogue, and I mean, the scene got cut, and everyone was leaving that place, and then Kalki actually literally, like, she grabbed me like this, she was like, Shiv, I can't hear what you're saying, speak up. So I think definitely it's given me an impetus to speak a little. I speak a lot. I've heard a thank for that.
I think it's 70% English. So the census certificate they've got is from English.
Well, language ko lekar to itni problem nahi thi, but we had to actually beep out a few words, and then they asked us to remove a few shots, but itni mushkil nahi aayi. I think I have to say that it was a smooth process. इरादा तो बहुत ज़्यादा करने का था, बट मिले 50 हैं अभी इन 5 सिटीज.
So the film is in English, and it so we are planning to follow what this Oscar and the international films follow the release strategy in India. So we'll be selecting the top 60-80 high-end cinemas, the multiplexes in Delhi, Bombay, Bangalore, Pune, Ahmedabad, and Hyderabad, and we'll in the first round we'll be releasing the film in these cities, and if the response is good, which we are very much hoping, we'll open it in more cities.
You know, there are two sides of it. The fact is that censor comes down heavily on things that you don't think necessary these days, especially in the age of internet, when you know you can watch pornography with the click of a button. So it doesn't really make sense in that way. But having said that, if there are restrictions within a country's law, then you have to follow those restrictions, and it should not stop you from making good work or even great work. My constant example for this is Iran. Look at the kind of restrictions they have. Look at the kind of cinema they make.
Rajat, taking off from that, first of all, I'll refrain from calling it a censor board. It's a film certification board. And that's all it does. And that's all it should do. But it's a bit of a conundrum, you know, like pretty ironical that for us to be able to see the film in its entirety and originality, we probably get retorted to ways and means like torrent. Because if today I come and see this film, for example, in the theater, I know now that there are a few things which have been missed out.
But I saw Moonlight 2 days back, and all the cuss words have been beeped out. And because they beeped out at the final go, so even the sound stops, and it's terrible for the film.
Yeah.
But you know, like I said, it's the law of the country. Unless you change the law, and we should. But unless that changes it.
But isn't that also providing an impetus for people to kind of download and see the film in?
Maybe. I'm sure some people do that.
Okay, last question.
Hello. Last question, death in the Ganj film jo aapki aa rahi hai. कोंकणा सेन शर्मा वो मामे फिल्म फेस्टिवल में दिखाई गई थी आई थिंक द फिल्म इज डिलेड और समथिंग
But I think they're just looking for a good release date.
सेंट्रल रूम दीजिएगा माइक ओके हमने जो ट्रेलर देखा ट्रेलर बहुत ही इंटरेस्टिंग है और अच्छे रिस्पांस और अप्रिशिएशन मिले हैं क्या कहना चाहेंगे इस ट्रेलर को
देखिए ट्रेलर तो एक इनविटेशन है एक न्योता है फिल्म के लिए अगर ट्रेलर लोगों को अच्छा लगता है तो शायद बाकी फिल्म देखेंगे सो दैट इज़ द इंटेंशन ऑफ एन इंट्रीगिंग ट्रेलर आई एम ग्लैड यू फाइंड इट इंट्रीगिंग सो होपफुली यू विल कम एंड वॉच द फिल्म
अच्छा फिल्म का जो टाइटल है वो कर्मा है मंत्रा है मतलब
यार ट्रेलर अच्छा लगा और टाइटल लेकर बोल रहे हो
मंत्रा है
जी
तो मतलब ये किस तरह का ये फिल्म होने वाला है आपकी नज़रिए से मतलब ऑडियंस को किस तरह से रिलेट करेगी
देखिए फिल्म एक बहुत स्पेसिफिक टाइम में सेट है लेट 90s में जब हिंदुस्तान में बदलाव आ रहा था ग्लोबलाइजेशन की बात हो रही थी लिबरलाइजेशन की बात हो रही थी उस टाइम में फिल्म सेट है और एक बिजनेस फैमिली के बारे में है आई एम प्लेइंग कपिल कपूर हु इज़ द हेड ऑफ दैट बिजनेस एंड ही इज़ स्ट्रगलिंग टू सर्वाइव एंड हिज फैमिली इज ऑल्सो फॉलोइंग अपार्ट एट द सेम टाइम सो दिस इज़ द फिल्म इट्स अ फिल्म अबाउट अ फैमिली इट्स अ फिल्म अबाउट चेंजिंग टाइम्स देखिए ऑडियंस क्या लेके जाती है क्या किस तरह से रिलेट करती है इट्स अ फिल्म ऑफकोर्स विदाउट सॉन्ग्स विदाउट फाइट सीन्स विदाउट बिग स्टार्स So it is a niche film if you want to.
Yeah. Sir, आज तक आपने जितने भी किरदार निभाए सारे performance oriented है वो कपूर एंड सन्स हो या फिर आपने जितने भी आगे किरदार तो हर किरदार चुनने से पहले क्या thought process होता है और ये film चुनने का क्या reason है
देखिए मैं बहुत कम काम करता हूँ फिल्मों में क्योंकि ज़्यादातर एक तो बहुत अच्छी scripts नहीं लिखी जाती हैं और बहुत अच्छी अगर script अच्छी होती है तो उन scripts में मुझे role नहीं मिलता है And I don't want to do a small role for its own sake. So I wait for a meaty character, you know. I wait for a meaty part where I can sink my teeth into it. This is a very special script, Mantra, and it's a very special role for me. So from the moment I read it, I wanted to do this. There was no question about that.
जी इसके अलावा बड़ी जब फिल्में आती हैं तो छोटी फिल्मों को उतनी स्क्रीन या फिर उतना प्रमोशन करने का मौका नहीं मिल पाता तो उसके लिए आपका क्या मतलब ओपिनियन होगा जैसे कोई बड़ी फिल्म आ गई मंत्रा जैसी कोई छोटी फिल्म है तो मतलब मंत्रा जैसी फिल्म में कंटेंट ओरिएंटेड होते हैं लेकिन बड़ी फिल्म में कमर्शियली ज़्यादा स्क्रीन दी जाती है तो उसके लिए क्या ओपिनियन होगा
ये जो बात है ये फैक्ट है और ये हमारी जिंदगी का एक सच है और इसको ठुकराया नहीं जा सकता ये सच को मान लेने में ही अच्छाई है कि भाई बड़ी फिल्म आएगी बड़े स्टार के साथ फिल्म आएगी तो उसको 3,000, 3,500, 4,000 स्क्रीन मिलेंगी क्योंकि लोग ज़्यादा हैं जो उस तरह की फिल्में देखना चाहते हैं तो उससे कुछ झगड़ा नहीं है उसमें कुछ अनबनी नहीं है हम जिस तरह की फिल्में बनाना चाहते हैं या बनाते हैं या इंडिपेंडेंट सिनेमा जिसको आप बोलते हैं उसके लिए हमेशा एक लिमिटेड ऑडियंस ही रहेगी क्योंकि तो ये तो बात इट्स अ फैक्ट अब उसमें क्या झगड़ा करें कि भाई हमें क्यों ज़्यादा स्क्रीन नहीं मिले ये तो आपने इस तरह की फिल्म बनाई इसलिए नहीं मिले ज़्यादा स्क्रीन
जी कमिंग बैक टू मंत्रा आपका लाइव जीने का मंत्रा क्या है
माइक ऊपर दो थोड़ा
मेरा लाइफ जीने का मंत्रा क्या है
जी
कि आप वही करें जो आपको भाता हो जिसमें आपकी रुचि हो नहीं तो किसी और कारण से काम करने में कुछ फ़ायदा नहीं है सो इफ़ आई बिलीव इन अ सर्टन काइंड ऑफ सिनेमा इफ़ आई बिलीव इन अ सर्टन एस्थेटिक्स आई विल फॉलो दैट टू द लास्ट ब्रेथ ऑफ माई लाइफ
थैंक यू ओके बहुत बहुत स्वागत है कन्वर्सेशन में फिल्म वाले आपकी मंत्रा क्या कहना चाहेंगे इस फिल्म को लेकर काफ़ी इंटरेस्टिंग है ट्रेलर
एक्चुअली मैं काफ़ी सरप्राइज भी हूँ ये इतना पॉजिटिव रिएक्शन देखकर नॉट सरप्राइज क्योंकि इन अ वे की फिल्म बुरी है बट जस्ट सरप्राइज की एक ऐसी कभी कभार क्या होता है आपको एक फिल्म की डेस्टिनी नहीं पता होता तो ये जो फिल्म थी बहुत मुश्किलों से बनी है बिकॉज क्राउड फंडिंग थी अलग अलग प्रोड्यूसर्स आए और गए एंड सरप्राइजिंगली जिसने भी ये फिल्म आज तक देखी है मामी फिल्म फेस्टिवल में या दूसरे फिल्म फेस्टिवल्स में, अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल हैव रियली लाइक द फिल्म एंड द ट्रेलर इज गेटिंग एन एक्सीलेंट रिस्पॉन्स विच इज समथिंग वी आर ऑल वेरी हैप्पी अबाउट. तो यू नो इट्स ऑलवेज ग्रेट टू बी प्लेजेंटली सरप्राइज्ड एंड आई थिंक अगर आप अपना काम अच्छी तरह करें एंड लोगों को आपका काम पसंद आता है देन दैट्स अ ग्रेट फीलिंग.
आपका कैरेक्टर किस तरह का?
थैंक यू.
अब फिल्म में आपका जो कैरेक्टर है वो किस तरह का था? क्योंकि दो तरह की ऑडियंस है, उनको रिलेट कर पाना, उनको कन्विंस कर पाना आपके लिए चैलेंजिंग होगा.
नहीं, मेरे कैरेक्टर का नाम विराज कपूर है. हम लोग इस फिल्म में एक फैमिली हैं. मेरे जो फादर इस फिल्म में हैं वो है मिस्टर रजत कपूर. सो रजत कपूर एंड लूशन दुबे इज़ माई मदर एंड कल्कि मी एंड रोहन जोशी हम लोग उनके सिबलिंग उनकी फैमिली है, मतलब उनके बेटे और बेटियां हैं. एंड बेसिकली द थिंग इज़ कि द ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ द फिल्म वॉज कि ये एक डिसफंक्शनल फैमिली है. एक्सटर्नल सर्कमस्टांसिस की वजह से इस फैमिली के अंदर क्या क्या मतलब भेदभाव आ जाते हैं, दैट इज़ वॉट दिस फिल्म इज़ अबाउट. And I play the character of a young entrepreneur who kind of represents the new India which you have been seeing since 2002. An India which is very fierce, very ferocious, an India which is very ruthless. In a sense ki aaj kisi ke paas time nahi hai, you know, and as each day goes by ek din mein hum log aur bhi zyada cheeze karne ki koshish karte hain, you know. To so this guy represents the ruthlessness of the new age Indian.
Okay.
And his father, which is Mr. Rajat Kapoor, he represents the old India, jo matlab aiye sahab aiye baithiye chaliye baat karte hain, thoda wo ek wo aaram se karne wali jo cheeze hoti thi aur thoda sa ek orthodox method hota tha cheeze karne ka. So iske aur iske father ke beech mein bahut clashes hote hain because of their ideologies. So his father's ideology is very old school, he's got a very new age ideology, so that leads to a lot of clashes in the family between him and his father.
So Shiv, isse pehle you did Shaitan and now you are doing Mantra. Is it your mantra of success ki just do underrated movies because it's not commercial? So is it your success of Mantra?
I've done some movies in the middle also yaar. Yeah. To matlab meri pehli movie pe chale gaye uske baad kuch kiya hi nahi hai.
So is it your mantra of success?
No,
just do stick to the content.
No, it's not that. I'll be very I don't know what how others feel, but I think the thing is it depends on what's offered to you. Aur aapko us waqt kya offer kiya jata hai. Based on your choices in life you make a decision. Of course any actor, I think any actor regardless of commercial actor or whatever, if you want to call it indie cinema actor, any actor will always go for a script which is a good script. और अगर स्क्रिप्ट अच्छी होती है, अगर उसके मेकर्स अच्छे होते हैं, देन उसके बाद जाके फिल्म बनती है. सो फॉर मी इट वाज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, इट्स ऑलवेज बीन वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू सी व्हाट काइंड ऑफ फिल्म आई एम गोइंग टू बी अ पार्ट ऑफ. डज द स्क्रिप्ट ऑफ द फिल्म स्पीक टू मी? क्या ये फिल्म करने से मुझे कुछ सीखने को मिलेगा? क्या मैं इसमें कुछ कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट कर पा सकता हूँ कि नहीं? एंड ऑफकोर्स आपके जो चॉइसेस होते हैं, आई मीन इट्स नॉट लाइक ऑफकोर्स अगर आप अगर कह रही हैं कि अगर मैं एक अंडररेटेड फिल्म कर रहा हूँ, योर वर्ड्स नॉट माइन, but I don't think Shaitan was very underrated. I think Shaitan eventually found its audience later, which is the hope with any film. Aapko kisi film ki journey nahi pata hoti, wo choti si film hoti hai lekin kahan kitni badi film ban jati hai. So it just depends on what is offered to you and you have to make your decision based on that.
Okay, thank you so much and wish you all the best.
Thanks a lot.
ओके बहुत बहुत कॉन्ग्रेचुलेशन आपको ये अपनी नई फिल्म के लिए. वेरी इंट्रिगिंग और बहुत ही ज़्यादा अप्रिशिएशन मिल रहे हैं. क्या कहेंगे आप इस फिल्म को लेकर?
मैं बहुत खुश हूँ कि मंत्रा फाइनली रिलीज़ हो रही है 17th of March को. और दो साल पहले हमने ये शूट किया था और हमने क्राउड फंडिंग भी किया इस फिल्म के लिए. तो काफ़ी स्ट्रगल किया हमने बनाने के लिए. मुझे ये स्क्रिप्ट बहुत अच्छा लगा. ये 1990s में जब हमारी मल्टीनेशनल्स आए इंडिया में, तो इट्स अबाउट दैट कैसे हम हाउ वी चेंज्ड. जैसे हम देयर वाज द ओल्डर जनरेशन व्हिच वाज आवर पेरेंट्स जनरेशन जो काफ़ी traditional थे and then नया generation आ गया where we just wanted freedom and things. तो एक ही family के through हम ये struggle देखते हैं generation का divide जो है. So it's a very relevant film because we all I grew up in the 90s. So I completely understand that rebellious phase. जब मम्मी पापा को सुनाई नहीं सकती थी और कुछ भी करती थी एंड आई हैव आल्सो कम राउंड एंड यू नो नाउ हैव अ बेटर रिलेशनशिप विद माय पेरेंट्स तो आई थिंक द फिल्म इज अ वेरी रेलेवेंट सब्जेक्ट फॉर लॉट ऑफ आवर जनरेशन.
अच्छा इतना इंटरेस्टिंग टॉपिक होने के बावजूद भी ये फिल्म कमर्शियल क्यों नहीं है आपके नज़रिए से?
ये फिल्म कमर्शियल नहीं है क्योंकि बड़ी कमर्शियल कास्ट नहीं है और it's an indie subject. It's a subject which is about very real. It's not a over the top, larger than life escapist film. It's very much about our problems in our country and how we are dealing with them or not dealing with them. The conflicts that are arising. There's no songs in the film, so hard to sell it as a commercial film.
ओके आजकल बॉक्स ऑफिस नंबर्स के हिसाब से फिल्म को ब्लॉकबस्टर या फिर सुपरहिट साबित कर दिया जाता है. स्क्रीन काउंट को तो देखा ही नहीं जाता. स्क्रीन काउंट के हिसाब से जो प्रॉफिट होता है उसके हिसाब से तो देखा ही नहीं जाता. इस ट्रेंड को आप किस तरह से आप डिफाइन करेंगे?
या आई थिंक कि ये हमारी जिम्मेदारी है कि वी शुड better explain this and I think this is actually a journalist's responsibility to show the success of small films kyunki kaafi times agar if ek film 5 crore ke andar banaye hai most of the time it becomes a hit just in terms of numbers.
Shaitan bhi waisi
hai. Shaitan or any small budget film so many films have done really well in terms of budget but iske bare mein hum baat nahi karte hain. So I think it's very important to talk about the success of independent cinema.
हमारी कंट्री में हमारी फैमिलीज में ज़्यादातर देखा जाता है जो सोशल नॉर्म्स हैं या फिर ओल्ड मेंटालिटी है अभी भी कई जगह पर है. तो इस लगता है कि अब धीरे धीरे बदलाव आ रहा है आपकी नज़र से और फिल्मों के जरिए इसका प्रभाव भी पड़ रहा है.
बदलाव आ रहा है इन द सेंस दैट लोग बात कर रहे हैं इसके बारे में. पहले तो हम बात ही नहीं कर सकते थे. यू नो सब अंडर द कार्पेट ब्रश करते थे. हम सामने नहीं बात करते थे. अभी पब्लिक में लोग बात कर रहे हैं कि यू नो वी हैव दीज इश्यूज व्हाट एवर द इश्यूज माइट बी जेंडर इश्यूज जेंडर इक्वालिटी और यू नो एजुकेशन और सो मेनी अदर थिंग्स freedom of speech you know censorship issues these are all issues that abhi hum
ji
jo samne aa gaye hain aur aap bataiye kaun hai mummy
yaad aa rahi
ji lunch maine bhi nahi khaya to I just think that it's a good time where we have the media that is also representing all these issues a lot more as well as social media which is a very important platform nowadays. That's the first step. Next generation might understand it. For I think this generation we're just talking about it. Next generation might come to accept things.
Okay, film ka naam kyunki mantra hai to real life ka mantra kya hota hai uske bare mein agar hum aap se nahi jane to
my mantra in life is just do better than before. Just okay. keep learning. I think that life is a school and you never stop learning and the more you learn the more you live.
Iske alawa aur kaun kaun se platforms honge jin par hum aapko dekh payenge?
Any upcoming project you want to share?
I'm doing of course Death in the Ganj, Coco's film which should release. Wo film ready hai. Phir main ek web series bhi shuru kiya hai. It's called Smoke for Eros now.
Okay.
Aur I'm doing a film called Scholarship by Raman Bhardwaj jisme main aur Konkana Sen Sharma acting kar rahe hain aur that's it.
Okay.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.